Condoms, about prep, and as a matter of fact, that's why you guys are here, right?
Yeah.
Yeah? Y'all didn't come to see MJ, you come to see talk about condoms and prep, right?
All of the above. All of the above.
Okay, yeah. Awesome. So I know that there's been a big debate, not only with these two beautiful ladies.
Yes,
what
the debate?
I don't know, girl. However, there's a debate. However, we're going to do a debate for a good purpose tonight. Today. Alright, so really, really quick, let me introduce the board. Again, I'm Director of Operations Devontae Whitson.
With the cake.
The cakes.
Yes.
Two thumbs up. I'm going to bring up the president of our organization, president of the DC chapter, Devin Barrington Ward. Devin is so important and vital to what we do. Devin gives us the vision of what we do, and then the rest of us just pretty much handle it, right? Let's bring out Joe Biden. AJ King.
Our
Vice
President.
AJ King.
Listen, he ain't got none in the back, but it's definitely in the front.
Any man that ain't blessed with no motherfucking case in the back, he's blessed with me in the front.
I want to introduce Terrence J. Ford. He's director of marketing. So all the marketing that you see, this is Jonathan. I want to introduce Jonathan Lights. He's our esteemed board member. A lot of things that we do, we couldn't pull off without But he's our director of advocacy. Again, what we do, we like to entertain you guys, but at the same time, we want to make sure that you guys get a message and be educated throughout what we do. So that's good. I know he's not here, but let's give Chris Johnson a hand clap.
Let me start off by thanking you all for agreeing to bring the Queen's Court to this motherfucker. Not anyone would say. First of all, let me start off by thanking you all for agreeing to participate in our PrEP versus condoms debate. Our goal for this discussion is to educate people about both the benefits and limitations of condoms and PrEP for HIV prevention. Since the first latex condom made its debut in 1920, the condom has become the most recognized and readily available form of contraception. With its effectiveness against pregnancy, HIV, and many STDs, condoms remain popular. But with anything comes limitations. Sister, don't let me go. Please don't make me preach it here. While condoms are effective, they do not prevent other common STDs,
the claps,
HPV,
fishy smelling odor, y'all knew what it was back in the 75, 4, 6, 7.
Sister, let me finish this goddamn thing. Beyond the public health implication and statistics, condoms just are not as fun as raw sex. Now, we know that, bitch. I love a little. I like a little dick every now and then. Look, what that like? Wait, hold on, DJ. I like a little what every now and then?
Dick every now and then.
I like a little raw dick.
I love some raw dick every now and then. Hey, well, I'm fine. Look at my friend in the lake.
Oh, look at my friend.
I love a little dick every now and then.
But I gotta take my prep before I get that little dick. Millennials in one study said they never, ever, or rarely use condoms.
Oh. You know it don't feel the same.
It don't feel.
It's cold.
Yeah.
It got lint on it.
Lint.
It ain't warm. You know that head that big when it's raw, it's warm going in.
Yes.
That plastic is cold.
You got to feel that thrust.
Yes. And the ridge is in that dick.
And that dick.
Yes.
You got to feel it in your neck and your back. Sus, let me tell you something. You said this, and I quote you, bitch. The best head comes from a thug. The good bitch, big and long.
They said, is the black man's dick so big that he can't wear a condom? That's why he need prayer.
No, they make room.
We don't know.
Is that a myth?
We gonna find out the answers to that today. All right. Now, approved by the FDA in July of 2012, PrEP has revolutionized HIV prevention, allowing people to enjoy raw sex without the fear of contracting HIV, as PrEP provides upwards of 92 to 99% effectiveness
at preventing HIV.
Right.
But you can still get gonorrhea.
You can get herpes.
You can get herpes.
Chlamydia.
The clap.
Loose foot.
Sour puss. Gentle work.
Broken pussy. Broken
pussy. Scales on your head. Souls in your throat. So I'm not clean where I was.
bitch. I love a little bit every now and then. Sister, where I was at, girl? You done threw me out with this crap.
You talked about condoms are 70-99% effective at preventing HIV, but not solvable. Okay.
Now listen, while PrEP does provide protection from HIV, it does not protect people against STDs like gonorrhea and chlamydia. PrEP is similar to medications for people who are living with HIV, and like medications can prevent people who are negative from becoming HIV positive. This panel debate will seek to inform people in a fun way about how condoms or PrEP can be great options for their personal prevention and strategy.
I'm leaving.
See, like after PrEP came out, they just got butt wild.
Butt wild.
Butt wild.
Butt wild. Legs to the moon.
Legs to the moon,
bitch.
Ball to the wall.
Which is better, condoms or PrEP?
We gonna find out
both.
It could
both.
Be.
Both.
Both.
Both. So before we make sure that we get these questions answered, let's take some quick facts. Bottom line, bitch, we dealing with facts, okay?
We're dealing with facts.